information is, so in October, we published the call. The comment period ends January 28th. A typical comment period for a call for information would be 45 days, but after collaborating with the state, knowing that the holidays and the elections were coming up, we decided to have a 100-day comment period. So that comment period ends January 28th of next year, 2019. So the call, as I stated, we have the three call areas that was in the call, and it identifies those are the areas that we're looking at right now, in which we may, after we receive the comments and information from the call, identify areas that we would designate as wind energy areas. Once we were to designate those wind energy areas, then we would start the NEPA process for looking at lease issuance and site assessment activities. And we also request additional nominations from potential developers on areas they're interested in within those call areas that they think are appropriate for leasing from the developer side. I did want to point out that I talked earlier about the two unsolicited lease requests that we did receive, one on the North Coast and one on the Central Coast off Morro Bay. Those areas are included in our call areas, so it's encompassed in there. We expect that any leasing offshore California will be competitive. And just wanted to point out that the call areas, it's not a decision to lease. It's not a decision on the lease area at this time. It's just the specific areas that we're looking at. So I had a presentation yesterday, so I went through all the data that we got to this. Ultimately, this is the Central California call areas, what we did. Some of the data and information that we took into consideration when we developed these was, you know, distance from shore, the water depth. So to the westernmost boundary of these call areas is to the 1,100 meter bathymetry line. We also looked at existing infrastructure. So in Central California, there's the power plant off Morro Bay, as well as Diablo Canyon, which will be decommissioning soon. So that's existing infrastructure that is there. You'll notice, for those of you who are familiar with the San Diego area, San Onofre is already, there's existing infrastructure there, but as shown in the slide that Commissioner Douglas had, the wind isn't that great down there, so we're not looking at that area at this time. One of the other aspects that we looked at on the environmental side is, and I had some slides on this yesterday, is marine mammals as well as bird data. Generally speaking, the closer you get to shore, the higher there are those resources. So we moved the call areas out. That